This story takes place somewhere between the 5th and 6th century BC in the Babylonian Empire. When King Nebuchadnezzar conquered Jerusalem, he ordered the sharpest young men to be taken back to Babylon. Approximately around 593 BC, as a young man of about 16, Daniel was taken in the first group of captives. And even though he was a captive, he eventually rose to be prime minister of Babylon. He was a man of faith, prayer, and courage, and nothing could get him to go against God or his commandments. He held high positions under kings Nebuchadnezzar, Belshazzar, Darius, and Cyrus. God used Daniel to interpret dreams of the kings, and as a result, he was given important jobs in the government. Under King Darius, Daniel was one of the top three administrators of the entire kingdom. Because Daniel had distinguished himself among all of the other administrators, the king planned on setting him over the entire kingdom. As a result, the other administrators became jealous and tried to find ways to bring charges against him. But they were unable to do so because they could find no corruption or negligence in him. He was only found to be trustworthy. They realized the only basis for charges against him would have to do something with the law of his God. Daniel's fellow administrators went to King Darius and had him issue an edict and enforce a decree that anyone who prays to any god or man during the next 30 days, except to the king, should be thrown in the lion's den. Now when Daniel learned that the decree had been published, he went home to his upstairs room where the windows opened toward Jerusalem. Three times a day he got down on his knees and prayed, giving thanks to his God, just as he had done before. Daniel's fellow administrators caught him doing this and brought it to the attention of King Darius. When the king heard of it, he was greatly distressed. He was determined to rescue Daniel and made every effort until sundown to save him, but to no avail. So the king gave the order and had Daniel thrown into the lion's den. The king said to Daniel, "May your God, who you serve continually, rescue you." The king returned to his palace and spent the night without eating and without any entertainment being brought to him, because he could not sleep. At the first light of dawn, he hurried to the lion's den. He called out to Daniel in an anguished voice and said, "Daniel, servant of the living God, has your God, who you serve continually, been able to rescue you from the lions?" Daniel answered, "O king, live forever. My God sent his angel, and he shut the mouths of the lions. They have not hurt me, because I was found innocent in his sight. Nor have I ever done any wrong before you, O king." The king was overjoyed and gave orders to lift Daniel out of the den. When he came out, they discovered that no wounds was found on him because he had trusted in his God. Daniel's false accusers were then thrown into the lion's den along with their wives and children. Before they reached the floor of the den, the lions overpowered them and crushed all of their bones. Then King Darius wrote to all the peoples, nations, and men of every language throughout the land, "May you prosper greatly. I issue a decree that in every part of my kingdom, people must fear and reverence the God of Daniel. For he is the living God and he endures forever. His kingdom will not be destroyed. His dominion will never end. He rescues and he saves. He performs signs and wonders in the heavens and on the earth. He has rescued Daniel from the power of the lions." So Daniel prospered during the reign of King Darius and the reign of the next king as well.